Hi students, today we are going to study about memory. Okay, so memory is an inevitable part of an embedded system. Okay, so there are two types of memories. One is ROM and another one is RAM. Okay, so ROM is generally used for storing program memory. Okay, so in this lecture we are going to discuss about program storage memory or ROM. Okay. So the program storage memory, as the name indicates, it will store the program or instructions. Okay, so this ROM is generally used for storing the programs, instructions, configuration settings, etc. Okay, so generally we will say like it is used for storing the firmware in the embedded system. Okay, so the main advantage of this ROM is it will retain its content even if the power is lost or power is turned off. Okay, so it is generally known as non-volatile storage memory. Non-volatile storage memory. Okay, so depending on the fabrication, erasing and programming technology that we are using, it is divided into different types. This ROM is divided into different types. Okay, so in this lecture we are going to discuss about all the different types of ROMs that are available. Okay, so ROM is also called a code memory. Okay, so we have different types of ROM. That is, PROM is there, programmable read-only memory. That is PROM. Okay, then masked ROM is there. Okay, then EPROM is there and EEPROM is there. Okay, so we will discuss all these things separately. First one is masked ROM. Okay, so what is this masked ROM? Masked ROM means one-time programmable memory. So we can program it only one time. Okay, so this is a hardwired technology that is used for storing the data. Okay, only one time we can program, and this master ROM will be always be pre-programmed. Okay, pre-programmed by using masking and metallization process. Okay, so that is the process that will be used for preparing the masked ROM. Okay, so the primary advantage of this masked ROM is low cost and high volume production, because it is produced in the manufacturer in the factory. So at a particular time we can manufacture many number of masked ROMs, and the program that is inside this ROM is fixed. Okay, so low cost because of high volume production. Okay, so different mechanisms were used for developing this masked ROM. One is the creation of enhancement or depletion mode transistor through channel implant technology. That is one type of technology that we are using. Another is by creating the memory cell either by using standard transistor or high threshold transistor. Okay, so these are the two types of technologies where we can develop a masked ROM. Okay, so the major disadvantage is like once the firmware is written into this ROM, it cannot be reprogrammed. We cannot modify the firmware. Once the program is written, it is over. If the program is wrong also, that memory we have to throw it away, because it is one time programmable. Okay, so another, if you consider in terms of bits also, the bits are also not changeable. Okay, so MROM is permanent in bit storage. Okay, so it is not possible to alter the bit information also. Okay, so these are the major drawbacks of masked ROM. Okay, next is simple PROM. Okay, programmable read only memory. Okay, so this is also similar to master row. Okay, it is also one time programmable, but it is not pre-programmed by the manufacturer. Okay, so the user has to program it, so it will come blank. No program will be present inside this PROM. Okay, it will come blank and the user is responsible for programming the device. Okay, so PROM, or it is called OTP, that is one time programmable. OTP means one time programmable. Okay, so it consists of a nichrome or polysilicon wires that are arranged in a matrix. Okay, so these wires will act as fuses. Okay, so as you can see here, these are the fuses. This is fuse, this is fuse. Okay, so we can either blow the fuse. Okay, so if we blow the fuse, means what? There will be no connection between these two. If you are not blowing, there will be a connection between these two. Okay, so if the fuse is blown, then it represents a zero. Or if the fuse is not blown, then it represents what? One. If the connection is there, it represents one. If the connection is not there, then it represents a zero. Okay, so the default state is logic one. Okay, normally the fuse will be there. That means it represents a logic one. Okay, so this on-time programmable memory is widely used for commercial production of embedded system. Okay, so we developed a prototype and we want to write the firmware to the embedded system. In that case, we will use this OTP. Okay, so this OTP is non-programmable. We cannot program this OTP. Once it is programmed, we cannot again program this OTP. That is, OTP cannot be reprogrammed. Okay. Next one is erasable read-only memory, or EPROM. Okay, so this is one type of memory that is available previously. Okay, so it gives the flexibility that we can program, we can reprogram, again we can program, again we can. So this programming can be done in many ways. Okay, so this erasable programmable memory consists of a window. Okay, so through that window we will provide ultraviolet rays for 20 to 30 minutes. Okay, then the entire memory will be erased. Okay, so during the developmental phase of a product, this OTP is very useful. We can use it for writing the program, again rewriting, then again we are rewriting. Okay, so once the program is finalized, then we can go for what? Some permanent ROM memory, like ROM or master ROM. Okay, so this EPROM stores the bit information by charging the floating gates of the FET. Okay, so there will be floating gates. So here, okay, this is the floating gate. So when we allow ultraviolet radiation, okay, so when we provide some voltage, okay, this gate will be charged and a bit will be stored. Okay, so we need a high voltage to charge this floating gates. So by applying high voltage, we can add bit information. Okay, so another one thing is a quartz crystal window is provided here. Okay, so it is used for erasing the stored information. Okay, so if the window is exposed to ultraviolet rays for 20 to 30 minutes, the entire memory will be erased. Okay, so this is the advantage of EPROM. Okay, another one is the advanced version. It is electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Okay, electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Okay, so this EEPROM memory gives the flexibility to reprogram the same chip using electrical signals. There is no need for any ultraviolet radiations. Okay, using electrical signals we can reprogram. Okay, so the information that is contained in the EEPROM, okay, can be altered using electrical signals in the register level or byte level. So that is also possible. Okay, so this chip includes erase mode. Okay, in this erase mode all the program will be erased. Okay, so it can be done within a milliseconds. So if you compare with the EEPRO, it requires more than 20 to 30 minutes, okay, to erase the program. So here it requires only what, milliseconds. Within a milliseconds everything will be erased and we can write the new program. Okay, so the only limitation is like what, capacity. Okay, so the capacity of this EEPROM is limited. Okay, so it will be like a few kilobytes or maximum 1 MB will be available inside this EEPROM. Okay, so this EEPROMs are present inside this microcontroller or these embedded system devices. Okay, so this is not a separate entity. Okay, it is already present inside the microcontroller. Okay, so when we charge, the action of the control gate is impeded and charged or uncharged. It will change the state, that is 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, okay, based on the operation that we are performing. Okay, so next one is flash memory. Okay, so that is the SD card, that type of memories that we are using. Okay, so this flash memory is a variation of EEPROM. Okay, so it uses the latest ROM technology. Okay, that is used for developing this flash. Okay, so the difference between EEPROM and flash is it is reprogrammable and it has high capacity. The memory card, as you see, it comes in GBs, gigabytes. Okay, so this flash memory is organized as sectors or blocks or pages. Okay, so there is no need to erase the whole memory. So we can select particular sectors and we can erase it. Again, select sectors, we can erase it. That is possible. Okay, so this flash memory is organized in sectors or blocks. Okay, we can select particular sectors and we can erase or reprogram that particular sector itself. Okay, so this flash memory stores information in an array of floating gates or MOSFET transistors are used for storing this bits. Okay, so this erasing can be done in sector level or page level without affecting other sectors. There is no need to erase the whole memory. So we can select the memory and we can erase it. Okay, so each sector or page should be erased before reprogramming. Okay, so the maximum number of times that we can reprogram is like 100s or thousands or 5000 or 10,000. That much times we can reprogram this flash memory. Okay, so thank you for listening to this lecture.